All right, let's practice counting protons, neutrons, and electrons in atoms and ions. Typically, the way this question is asked is you will get a symbol. For example, you might see the symbol that looks like this and be asked how many protons, neutrons, and electrons there are based on this symbol. Another thing that you might be asked is to identify the atomic number and the mass number. The first thing I'm going to do is recognize that it's magnesium. You should be working on the symbols and their names. Magnesium is down here in the periodic table, and this number 12 on the periodic table, it's the number that goes sequentially, usually listed above the symbol on the periodic table, that is the atomic number. So the atomic number is 12 because this is magnesium. Magnesium always has an atomic number of 12. We also can use this to identify the number of protons. The number of protons is 12. The atomic number and the number of protons are always the same. Since this symbol is neutral, there's no charge written with it, the number of electrons is 12. So far we've got those. We might have seen this symbol with the number 12 written in the bottom left-hand corner. This is another way to demonstrate the atomic number on the symbol or the number of protons, but it's a little redundant because 12 is always the number we would see on the bottom left-hand corner for magnesium, and the number 12 would always be with magnesium. Magnesium would always have the number 12. So often we see this bottom left-hand number on the symbol left out, but it is the atomic number and the number of protons. It's also the number of electrons since this is neutral. The next thing that we look at is this 24 in the upper left-hand corner. That's where we see the mass number. So the mass number is 24. And from this value, we can get the number of neutrons, because protons plus neutrons equal the mass number. So if the mass number is 24 and there are 12 protons, there would be 12 neutrons. All right, let's look at another symbol. You might see the symbol this. All right. In this case, we see a magnesium again, but now the mass number is different, this number in the upper left-hand corner. This is an isotope of magnesium in the sense that it has a different mass number. It still has an atomic number of 12. The atomic number is 12. The number of protons is 12. That will not change because it's magnesium. Based on the mass number of 26, I can identify how many neutrons there are. 12 plus what equals 26? The number of neutrons is 14 in this case. 14 plus 12 is 26. And then the last piece of information I'll use is to get the number of electrons. The plus 2, I might also see it written as a 2 plus in the upper right hand corner, is the charge on the ion. I now have an ion of magnesium. The charge is due to a different number of electrons than protons. In the neutral atom, the protons and electrons were exactly the same to neutralize each other. But in this particular ion, I have 12 positive charges and I only have 10 negative charges. And the 10 negative charges come from the 10 electrons. So the number of electrons is only 10. The number of protons is 12. If I have 10 negatives and 12 positives, that leaves me with a leftover plus 2, and therefore there are 10 electrons in this symbol. All right, let's go back and work another one. If I give you the symbol, let's make one up. How about, all right. Au is gold, and it is down here on the periodic table. All right. It has an atomic number of 79. And that is also the number of protons. The 208 is the mass number, So the mass number is 208. And the number of neutrons can be determined by taking the mass number and subtracting off the number of protons. The protons plus neutrons equals 208, and so there would be 129 neutrons. 129 plus 79, you always want to double check that. Don't miss the question because you can't do the math. That is equal to the mass number of 208. So 129 plus 79 is 208. Since there is no charge written on this symbol, the number of electrons is exactly the same as the number of protons, which is 79. If I write the symbol with the charge, for example, if I write Au with a 4 negative charge, we can make up anything in terms of getting you to learn protons, neutrons, and electrons, even if they're not likely. This is not a likely ion of gold, but we can still count protons and neutrons and electrons for it. Even if I had the same isotope, the 208, the answers are still going to be a little bit different down here. Now the atomic number is still, the atomic number is 79 because it's gold. The number of protons is 79 because it's gold. The mass number is 208 because it's written right there in the upper left-hand corner. And the number of neutrons is 129 because 129 plus 79 is 208. But now I have a different number of electrons. Remember that the protons are positive, the electrons are negative, and so if I had exactly the same number as in this first example, there would be no charge. But since I have indicated an extra 4 negative charge, it also might be written as minus 4, that means I have 4 extra electrons. Neutral would be 79 electrons, and therefore with 4 extra, I must have 83 electrons. 79 plus 4 is 83. So I would have 83 electrons in this particular isotope with this particular symbol for gold.